Hi everyone and welcome back. So here in this video we are going to decide the front-end architecture which we are going to do with React and Firebase. Okay, so let's see, here we have our React application and we are going to use a lot of different things on React side. Let me just get the React.js. I think I will not be able to get it. So here is our React.js component which is a front-end. Okay, and here is our GraphQL API gateway. This is our API gateway, so we'll just mark it. This is our front end. Okay, and we have Firebase also. So this is the Firebase component. Let's just mark it so we know how the communication will work. Okay. We are going to, so all the authentication is happening with the help of Firebase. Firebase will provide us the token once user is logged in, and we will send this token for requesting the API data. And then this API gateway will talk to the respective services. And what these services will do is we will have a Postgres as a database, or MySQL based on whatever is our need. Okay. Now coming to the tools and technologies we are going to use. We are going to use Node.js plus Nestjs for writing our API backend everywhere. Whatever the microservice we are writing, we are going to use this. And we are going to use a type ORM as the ORM to talk to Postgres. So we'll talk about all tools and technologies we are going to use. This will talk to the Postgres and our GraphQL gateway will talk to this. Okay, so this is a typical application architecture we are going to have. I mean the how the components are communicating with one another. This is the Postgres database. Our auth0 service will also talk to Firebase for authorizing the token. Okay. Now coming to the libraries and all. Front end, we are going to use a template generator also. Like we are going to use atomic design. Atomic design of component, we are going to use a story book also. I will just mention all these things here. And then we are going to have some integration libraries to talk to Firebase, Fire tools, Fire store, and all. Okay, and we are mostly going to use React hooks and context API. We will see if there is a use case of using Redux, then we will think about it. So type ORM will help us to manage the migrations, seeders, and accessing the database. Okay. And here one authentication service will also talk to Firebase to validate the token. This API gateway will give us the GraphQL interface. Okay, this is all GraphQL. Okay, so to interact with this kind of a GraphQL interface, you need to have like Apollo client library. And similarly, you need to have Apollo server at the server side. And these all are REST interface. These are actually REST APIs. Okay, this is how our components will behave. Now, this is your user. It is sitting here. He will request the front end, or it can be a developer also. you'll be generating the components. Okay, I need a header, I need a footer, I need a sidebar, I need a menu list. All these components we'll be building using atomic design standards. Okay, once the component is built, we will do the integration with the GraphQL, GraphQL queries and mutations. Okay, so we will be sending the query, GraphQL API gateway will be responding us with the data, and then the same data will be published to all our components. And Firebase, we will be doing the Firebase integration with the React, so that we should be able to manage the users. We have a lot of features on Firebase. Okay, if you want to send a user as an OTP from with the help of mobile number, all these features we will explore with the Firebase. So first thing, we will baseline our front end, then we will explore Firebase, what all features we can do with the Firebase, then front end React integration with the Firebase. Step one is done, then we start designing the components. Parallelly, we will also start designing these REST APIs and their migrations, and then we will integrate all these REST services with the GraphQL gateway. Okay, so let's get started on this journey. It's going to be a long journey, but it's going to be interesting, and a lot of learning is there in this, because I'm going to use a lot of libraries on the front end and a lot of libraries with the GraphQL, either it is a Nestjs, Node.js. We will talk about a lot of things, how to manage authentication, authorizations, role-based authentication, authorization, all these things with these different microservices. Okay, stay tuned. I will be posting more videos on this, and you keep watching. Thanks, everyone.